Hello friends, I welcome you all in the second part of Family Gerenaceae. In the second part, we will cover one of the example of Family Gerenaceae, its classification, vegetative characters, reproductive characters, its floral diagram, and economic importance of Family Gerenaceae. Now, we are going to take the example, that is Geranium oscillatum. So look at this one. This is the habit of this plant. This is the flower. This is the flower. When we dissect it, it shows that the presence of 5 calyx, 5 corolla, then 10 androecium in 2 groups and pentacarpillary ovary. This is the fruit of the Geranium oscillatum. Now next, moving towards the classification of this plant, it belongs to kingdom Plantae. Then why it is Plantae one? Because it is a chlorophyll bearing plant. Then it belongs to division Angiospermae. Angiospermae means the ovary enclosed in ovary wall. It belongs to class Dicotyledoneae. What are the reasons for that? The reasons are, as they show presence of 2 cotyledons, tap root, and the leaf shows presence of reticulate venation. It belongs to series Rosaceae. Having the characters like that, the leaves are alternate and they show presence of axile placentation. The order Geraniales. The characters for that are, the flowers are pentamerous, hairy, and the fruit is capsule or dry caesocar. It belongs to family Geraniaceae, and our today's example is genus Geranium and the species Oscillatum. Then next, the vegetative characters. So under the vegetative characters, first come the habit. So according to our photograph, first slide, it is herb one. About the root system, as they belongs to dicot, they show presence of tap root system. Then the stem is erect, cylindrical, branch, and the characteristic feature of that is the stem is hairy. Okay, so here is stem is hairy and gland dotted. About the leaves are stipulate one, alternate or sometimes opposite phyllotaxy. The leaves are petiolate, means they show presence of stalk. Also the leaves are hairy one, they are also gland dotted, and the margins are ciliate margins, indented, pentafoliate, and the apex of leaf, it is acute. The next one, about the reproductive characters of that plant. The inflorescence, it shows is either cymose or biclustered type of inflorescence. Then the flowers are bracteate, bracteolate, pedicellate, complete, bisexual, pentamerous, hypogynous and actinomorphic. The calyx, sepals, they are 5 in number. They are free, that's why they are polysepalous. Sometimes they are fused or conate at the base and shows presence of imbricate aestivation. Then, corolla, the petals are 5 in number as the flower is pentamerous one. The corolla is polypetalous because petals are also free. Then it shows presence of imbricate aestivation or twisted aestivation, and the corolla shows presence of alternating nectariferous glands. The androecium, they are usually 10 in 2 orals, 5 plus 5. The anthers are basifixed and bithycus. The gynoecium is tri or pentacarpillary. The ovary is superior as the flower is hypogynous one. And as the placenta of ovule, it is at the central position. That's why it shows the presence of exile placentation. As the ovules are present at the center, that's why it is called as an exile placentation. And the type of fruit is capsule. The pollination in this plant takes place, that is entomophilus. Now let's take a look on the floral diagram. So see that this one is the bract. These lateral two, they are the bracteoles. So this one, if you see this one, one oral which is completely outside, one is completely inside, and remaining three, they are alternating with each other. It shows presence of imbricate aestivation. Then the next one, this one is the petals. So petals shows presence of twisted aestivation, and these petals are alternating with the nectariferous glands. So see this one, these are the nectariferous glands which are alternating with the petals. Then in the center, it shows presence of five carpels, and these five carpels, they are attached with each other, means it shows presence of syncarpus. They are syncarpus one. See this one, these are the ovules. We are attached to the center, that's why they show presence of exile placentation. Okay, so this is about the floral diagram. The next, moving towards the economic importance of the family. So as we already know that most of the members of this family, they have the attractive flowers and various type of leaf variations. That's why they are used as an ornamental plant and planted as indoor or outdoor plants in the gardens or hospitals. In spite of its ornamental value, these members are also used for the production of essential oils because they show presence of flavonoids. Also, most of the species, they have antibacterial, antimicrobial, antifungal and antioxidant properties. Due to presence of large number of secondary metabolites inside these family members, they are utilized as herbal medicines. The species like geranium and pelargonium, they are cultivated in the gardens for its showy and scented flowers. The Pelargonium reniformi, it is used as an herbal medicine. Then the geranium species, it is cultivated as an ornamental one. Then Erodium sicutarium, it is cultivated as an ornamental, and also it is used for extraction of essential oil. Then take a look on this species, they are used as an ornamental as well as for the production of essential oils, that is Erodium taxacum, Geranium carolinum, Geranium mole, Geranium sicutarium, Geranium botrys. Then most of the species of Pelargonium, Monosomia, California, Erodium, they have the ornamental value as well as the medicinal value, and they are used for the extraction of essential oils. These are the species of Erodium like Erodium ethiopicum, Erodium arum, Erodium astragaloides, Erodium botrys, Erodium cheum, Erodium chrysanthemum, Erodium carlinum. then the species of Iridium labelli, Iridium microphyllum, Iridium manisavi, Iridium glandulosum. These are the species which are cultivated for its essential oil and also used as an ornamental plants. See that these are again the species of Iridium. If you see that slide, you can see that most of the species from the genera Iridium, they are cultivated for production of essential oil, as well as they possess most attractive flowers, that's why they are cultivated as an ornamental one. See that. And this Iridium, it is one of the largest genera under the family Geraniaceae. Generally 430 species of Iridium, they are present under the genera. Just take a look on the species of Pelargonium. The species of Pelargonium, which is the second largest genera of the family Geraniaceae, which is used for the production of essential oil. Also, the leaves of that plant, they are used for extraction of essential oil. They also possess beautiful flowers, that's why they are planted as an ornamental plant, and they also possess the medicinal value. If you like this video, please like, subscribe my channel. Thank you.